Lauren is live in Cave Creek. Hey, Lauren.
Hey, Greg. Thanks. You know, you can't buy these shoes at Macy's, Neiman's, or any of your favorite retail stores for that matter. These are custom made and for your four-legged friend.
My name is Jeremiah Harris, and I'm a farrier, and they're tasked with the primary care of the horse's feet. I will always correct somebody if they refer to me as a horseshoer, because I think that defines somebody that just simply puts a shoe on and leaves. And I think today, as a farrier, in my mind, and I think in my colleagues' mind, when you say farrier, it encompasses the whole caretaking of the horse. I choose to make my own shoes because I do feel that it is much more of a custom fit and better for the horse. And the steel comes out at roughly around 2,000 degrees. It cools off pretty quickly. It just fits a lot better on the horse's foot. And the better that it can fit on the horse's foot, the more secure and the happier the horse will be. Annie agrees. I think it's everything, the connection. There's something unique about horses and about the history that humans have with horses. And it really got me hooked from an early age, and then it just kind of continued to grow and grow into the passion it is today. You know, modern civilization is built off the horse's back, and I think there's a connection there that maybe we're not really aware of, and that some people may have more than others, but I love everything about them.
So although Jeremiah loves what he does, he did fill us in that unfortunately this industry isn't regulated nationwide. He says to ask a lot of questions and also get to know the farrier you're currently working with. Here in Phoenix, I'm Lauren Marie reporting for Cronkite News.